Je suis ici aujourd'hui avec la vice-première ministre Freeland et les ministres Anand, Fraser et Wilkinson pour parler de ce qu'on continue de faire pour soutenir les Ukrainiens. Over the weekend, President Putin continued his brutal assault on Ukraine. But Ukrainians have held strong. The whole world is inspired by the strength and intensity of their resistance. And Canada will continue to deliver support for Ukraine's heroic defense against the Russian military. Yesterday, we announced that we would be sending new shipments of military supplies, including body armor, helmets, gas masks, and night vision goggles. Today, we are announcing that we will be supplying Ukraine with anti-tank weapons systems and upgraded ammunition. Of course, this is in addition to our three previous shipments of lethal and non-lethal equipment. It's encouraging to see so many of our partners also stepping up to deliver support and equipment to Ukraine. The international community is rallying to support democracy and the people of Ukraine. The Canadian Armed Forces will also be providing airlift support to transport supplies and aid and to contribute to other NATO efforts. Since this assault began, thousands of Ukrainian families have been fleeing to escape the violence. President Putin has created a refugee crisis. We've said we would be there for the people of Ukraine, and that includes making sure they can find safety here in Canada. We have bolstered our presence in the region and are fast-tracking immigration applications for Ukrainians who want to come to Canada. Pendant qu'on apporte de l'aide à l'Ukraine, on continue aussi à travailler avec nos alliés et partenaires pour s'assurer que l'agression russe ne reste pas impunie. Au cours des derniers jours, j'ai discuté avec plusieurs dirigeants mondiaux, incluant le président Biden, ainsi que des membres du G7 et d'autres partenaires européens. On a parlé de l'évolution de la situation et de nos actions concertées. Ensemble, on continue de prendre de nouvelles mesures pour obliger le président Poutine et ses oligarques à répondre de leurs actes et pour affaiblir la capacité de la Russie de financer cette guerre qu'ils ont choisie. On Saturday, alongside our allies and partners, we announced our support for removing several major Russian banks from the SWIFT payment system. This will leave these banks effectively disconnected from the international financial system. And to prevent the Russian central bank from undermining the impact of our sanctions, we are paralyzing its international reserve assets. As of this morning, Canadian financial institutions are barred from any transactions with the Russian Central Bank, and we are prohibiting any direct or indirect dealings in Russian sovereign debt. Aujourd'hui, on annonce en plus notre intention d'interdire toute importation de pétrole brut en provenance de la Russie, une industrie dont le président Poutine et ses oligarques ont grandement profité. Ce secteur représente plus d'un tiers des recettes du budget fédéral russe et même si le Canada n'en a importé que des quantités très limitées ces dernières années, cette mesure envoie un message puissant. De plus, on s'assure d'empêcher ceux qui sont complices des atrocités du président Poutine de fuir les conséquences de leurs actions. C'est pourquoi on a annoncé qu'on va empêcher les oligarques russes de se servir de leurs richesses pour s'acheter une citoyenneté à l'étranger et éviter les répercussions des sanctions. The Russian government is now experiencing the severity of our coordinated sanctions. It is increasingly clear that President Putin has made a grave miscalculation. Today, the ruble plunged to record lows, and the Russian stock market was forced to close. People across Russia and around the world are taking to the streets, demanding freedom for Ukraine. Our message is clear. This unnecessary war must stop now. The costs will only grow steeper, and those responsible will be held accountable. En ces moments difficiles, il est important de continuer à se fier aux faits. En Russie, le président Poutine continue de bloquer les médias indépendants et il se sert des médias contrôlés par l'État pour propager des faussetés et faire de la propagande au sujet de sa guerre injustifiée. On ne permettra pas une telle désinformation de se répandre au Canada. The CRTC is an independent body, and we will be asking them to begin the process to review Russia Today's presence on Canadian airwaves. The rigorous process is important when it comes to the independence of media in our country. But even ahead of that decision, major providers are already removing RT proactively. There is a significant amount of disinformation circulating from Russia, including on social media, and we all need to keep calling it out. Our government will continue to be a leader on this. Those who are witnessing the truth are seeing civilians being targeted, grandparents joining the fight, families with young children sheltering in subway stations, and people fleeing to the border with only a suitcase. These images are heartbreaking. And they lay bare the human costs of war. To support relief efforts in the region, our government continues to provide humanitarian aid. Canadians are stepping up to help Ukrainians, and we are ready to match that help. So, if you donate to the Canadian Red Cross Ukraine Humanitarian Crisis Appeal, our government will match your donation up to $10 million. This is in addition to the $50 million for development and humanitarian aid we've already committed. To the people of Ukraine, your bravery is truly remarkable. The whole world is watching your courage and your strength. We are deeply inspired as we honor your fight for freedom, for democracy, and human rights. Canada stands with you. Slava Ukraini! Merci.